Today, I'm going to talk about applying percentage change across columns. Let me show you the result. Let's say I want to calculate within September 23rd, the close and the open price for September 23rd, the percentage which is called the intraday percentage change. What I need to do is create a function called cPercentChange. The name cPercentChange can be anything, it's totally up to you. There are three parameters in a function. Let's take a look at how they are used. Here I create a column for table df, which I defined in the variable readData. This is the column new that is matched to this column new. This column is equal to a new table containing two columns. This one, column base, comma and a column target, only two columns. In my example, the open column is the column base, where the closed column is the column target. This table is stored in the df double square brackets, cobase, cotarget. In this table, I apply a percentage change function and I set the x is equals 1. What it means is when x is equals 1, it's done from column to column. If x is equals 0, it's done row by row. If you do it row by row, simply remove everything because x is equals 0 is by default. But here I specify x is equals 1 column by column. After finishing the two column table, remember to specify the column target so that the percentage will be placed on the right of column target. Otherwise, your percentage change will be placed under the column target, close column, which is not what you want and you can't run it. I tried it before, so move on with the function, return the result in new column, and then apply the dot round function to round to two digits. Alright, after that, if I skip these and print the intra change variable, here it has more than 2000 rows, so I put dot tail to show only the last 5. Then control B, run the program, then I should see this. Date, and then -1.49. This column looks the same as the intra-change column, but this column doesn't have the intra-change title because when you look at the intra-change variable here, it's just an array, a column, with the index of date. So, in the table df, I have to explicitly create a column. Let's say I don't want this column to be intra-change, just call it I. When I print it out, remember to change it the same as I. Control boy and run it. Then, this one becomes column I. That's why I don't create a column inside the intra-change function, because I want to keep it open. Here I can create a new column that can be completely different from what I did in intra-change, which offers higher flexibility. Let's say it can be equal to intra-change multiply whatever variables, then a column name is not necessarily intra-change, it can be something else. That's why I don't create new columns directly in the function. Let me change it back to intra-change because I need it here. I know the names can be pretty confusing. That's why I shot this video to help my memory. So that's what we did today. Across the two columns, calculate the percentage change. That's it for today. Ciao.